All right, the latest news break now coming in from right outside the Delhi Chief Minister's residence. Swati Maliwal has been taken inside the Chief Minister's residence to recreate the scene. Mind you, there is an FIR lodged with grave charges on the secretary of the Delhi Chief Minister, Bibha, and Swati Maliwal at the back of recreating the entire incident of what went down, what she claims was a deadly assault on her. And she has now gone inside the Delhi Chief Minister's residence to recreate the entire sequence of events with the Delhi police. My colleague Shreya Chatterjee joins us from there. Shreya, what more can you add?
Preeti, right now it seems like that the recreation of the crime scene is almost complete. As we are stationed over here, Swati Maliwal is expected to come out any moment. She had appeared over here at least half an hour back while the Delhi police team was already stationed inside along with an FSL team. Now they have gone inside the drawing room where the alleged assault took place to piece together the entire crime scene that has been detailed by Swati Maliwal in her statement before the police and also before the magistrate. She will be coming out any moment as we get these visuals. Apart from an FSL team, the additional DCP of North, who's actually investigating the entire matter, is also present inside. The reason that the Delhi police has got her to recreate the crime scene, because as we're learning from our sources, possibly there's no CCTV inside the drawing room of the Chief Minister, so they will only be able to piece together the CCTVs that they get from the camp office and the entrance. But what exactly happened inside, they have taken the duty of the roster of all the officials who are present on that day, and now they will be again called in for their statements of what transpired on the 13th of May. As of now, we can, from the visuals, say that it looks like the crime scene involving Swati Maliwal looks to be almost complete, as she will be stepping out any moment from the CM's residence.
All right, you know, Shreya, stay with me. I'm going to come right back to you. My colleague Shreya joining us right outside the Chief Minister's residence where Swati Maliwal is recreating the crime scene along, with the Delhi police there. Expected out any time, you're going to get to it. But on the other side, a full-blown war has now erupted where the Aam Aadmi Party has disowned its own Rajya Sabha MP, saying that she is now a representative of the Bharatiya Janata Party and all her charges are fake, as per the Aam Aadmi Party. A press conference was held by Aatishi a short while ago, where as the back of a video that has been making the rounds, the Aam Aadmi Party Mantri Aatishi rubbished the assault charges made by Swati, claiming she was sent to the Chief Minister's house by the BJP and then forcibly she tried to enter the CM's residence. Not just that, after she referred to the video of Maliwal at the house, claiming no injuries can be seen and she appears to be at ease. Meanwhile, the AAP MP is currently at the Chief Minister's house with the Delhi cops to recreate the alleged incident.
Bharatiya Janata Party ne ek saazish rachi, ek shadyantra racha, aur us shadyantra ke tahat Swati Maliwal ji ko दिल्ली के मुख्यमंत्री अरविंद केजरीवाल जी के घर 13 मई को सुबह सुबह भेजा गया। इस षड्यंत्र का इरादा था अरविंद केजरीवाल जी पर झूठे आरोप लगाना। स्वाति मालीवाल जी इस षड्यंत्र का चेहरा थी, स्वाति मालीवाल जी इस षड्यंत्र का मोहरा थी। उन्होंने अपनी कंप्लेंट में लिखा है कि उनका सर टेबल पे लगा और उनका सर फट गया। उन्होंने लिखा है कि उनके कपड़े फाड़े गए, उनकी शर्ट के बटन फाड़े गए, लेकिन जो आज वीडियो सामने आया है वो बिल्कुल इसके विपरीत सच्चाई दिखाता है। सिर्फ एक चीज दिख रही है कि वो पुलिस को धमका रही हैं, वो विभव कुमार जी को धमका रही हैं, ऊंची आवाज में धमका रही हैं, और कहीं पर भी वो इस बात का जिक्र तक नहीं करती कि किसी ने उनको छुआ है या किसी ने उन पर हमला किया।
All right, you know, This is what Atishi said today. However, you had Sanjay Singh from the Aam Aadmi Party just 4 days ago admitting in a press conference that the PA of Arvind Kejriwal had misbehaved with Swati Maliwal and action would be taken. Listen in.
निंदनीय घटना घटित हुई, उन्होंने स्वाति मालीवाल जी के साथ बहुत बदतमीजी की, अभद्रता की।
इस पूरे मुद्दे पर संजय सिंह जी को एक ही पक्ष उपलब्ध था, अब दोनों पक्ष हमारे सामने उपलब्ध हैं। ये वीडियो ना सिर्फ हमारे सामने बल्कि पूरे देश के सामने है। ये वीडियो साफ कर देता है कि स्वाति मालीवाल जी ने जो कुछ कहा वो साफ साफ झूठ था।
You know, joining me right now is my colleague Amit, but we're going to cut across back to the Chief Minister's residence where Swati Maliwal right now exiting after recreating the crime scene along with the Delhi police. These are visuals coming in, a scramble there to get in a word of what Swati Maliwal says. Of course, she has reacted at the back of the video that has been leaked of her sitting on a couch and arguing with the security staff of the Delhi Chief Minister. And she has tweeted out saying that truth will emerge once proper CCTV images are revealed. Shreya, over to you. Swati Maliwal exiting the Chief Minister's residence.
Well, absolutely. Swati Maliwal has exited the residence of the Chief Minister. We can say that the crime scene recreation is complete, and that's the reason she's left the residence. As Swati Maliwal had also suggested, that the CCTV has become extremely crucial. As I'm pointing it out, it's the camp office and the main entrance of CCTVs that the Delhi police are off. They might get hand off. Apart from that, they will also be questioning the ones who are there on the duty, and also the visual, that video that was leaked. There were certain Delhi police officials who were also seen. So all of their questions will become very pertinent. But as of now, Swati Maliwal's part of the story and the entire piecing of the crime sequence has been completed by the Delhi police in the presence of the senior officials, including the additional DCP North, who's heading the entire investigation in the matter.
You know, Shreya, stay with me. There's more news coming in. It seems that the Delhi Chief Minister's personal assistant, Bibhav, has now filed a counter FIR. There's word also coming in that more videos will follow now. We're going to try and get in an understanding. Shreya, to bring you in, it does seem that the Delhi Chief Minister's personal assistant has followed up with a counter FIR now.
Well, that's what also Atishi in her press conference mentioned, Preeti, that there's a complaint that has now been given by Bibhav Kumar through an email, is what we're learning from our sources, to the Delhi police. Now, the Delhi police will also be going through the entire details of the FIR, and based on that, it will be the decision of the Delhi police that whether or not they will be filing a counter FIR in the matter. Meanwhile, they're looking for Bibhav Kumar. Twice they had visited the residence of Bibhav Kumar in the national capital, and in all likelihood, the Delhi police will move in for stringent actions, because Preeti, remember, the sections in the FIR that Swati Maliwal has filed is extremely serious of the nature, which is 308, 354B. Some of them are non-bailable as well. So while Vibhav Kumar has filed an FIR, trouble still mounts for him based on the FIR that's already been registered on Swati Maliwal's complaint.
Shreya, do we have an understanding on where are these leaked videos coming from? And because it seems to be an incomplete video, though one can see Swati Maliwal sitting on a couch arguing with the security, it really doesn't establish much.
Well, Preeti, the videos came from unverified sources. No one really quoted where these videos came from. However, the kind of endorsement that followed from the Aam Aadmi Party of these videos, which includes the likes of Atishi, Saurabh Bharadwaj, including the Aam Aadmi Party official handle on the platform X, it suggests that if not released, Aam Aadmi Party clearly endorses that video. However, when we spoke with Delhi police sources, this is a mere clip of a few seconds. This does not discredit what Swati Maliwal has entirely given in a कंप्लेन बिकॉज वॉट हैपन बिफोर एंड वॉट हैपन आफ्टर इज समथिंग विच इज स्टिल नॉट कम आउट एंड दिल्ली पुलिस सजेस्ट दैट इफ देर इज एनी फॉर्म ऑफ एविडेंस ऑन आइदर पार्टी दे शुड बी सबमिटिंग द सेम.
लेट्स क्विकली डिप इन and understand what was this 51 second video about. It's incomplete, but this is what the video suggests. We leave it for our viewers to decide.
I will do it.
आज मैं इन लोगों को सबको बताऊं.
हाँ बता देना वो वो आपका है.
आप मेरे को डिस्टिंक्टली से बात करेंगे.
A 51 second video taken on May 13th at the Delhi Chief Minister's residence has now emerged.
नहीं अब यही होगा जो करना है.
The video purportedly shows AAP MP Swati Maliwal having a verbal argument with Arvind Kejriwal staff. She's also seen sitting on a sofa. While India Today can't independently verify the authenticity of the video, Swati Maliwal herself has hit out at the Chief Minister's aide and her alleged attacker, Vibhav Kumar, saying that it's an attempt by the political hitman to save himself. She's also called for the CCTV footage of the room to be revealed. Earlier in the day, the former DCW chief recorded her statement at Delhi's Tees Hazari Court under Section 164. She was seen struggling to walk as she came out of court. Swati Maliwal was seen walking slowly and appeared to be in pain as she went for a medical at AIIMS Delhi on Wednesday. She's accused Kejriwal's aide Vibhav of physical assault and verbal abuse. And while an FIR has been lodged, Vibhav remains untraceable. With Shreya Chatterjee and Amit Bharadwaj in Delhi, Bureau Report, India Today.
What we are going to do, viewers, is keep a keen eye on all developments in this case. These are grave charges made by a sitting Rajya Sabha MP. And what comes of it, especially in terms of legally what action will be taken, will there be an arrest, will Vibhav get bail, all of that, the politics around it, we are going to get you the latest.